Hi, I'm Ronnie Chatterjee. I'm a senior product manager in the Azure data team. I work on the SQL Server product, and today I'm excited to show you what we have built as a data visualization experience in Azure Data Studio. Let's get started. In Azure Data Studio, you have a product which gives you a data visualization as well as an experience to work over data anywhere, whether it's data on premises as well as data inside big data clusters. So in this edition of Azure Data Studio, as you can see, I have a SQL database edge and a SQL Server big data cluster I'm connected into. Now, in Azure Data Studio is built on top of extensions. So one of the things which Azure Data Studio provides is an ability to install any extension which you may like for your data operation. So here, one of the extensions which we are going to install today is called SandDance. SandDance is a data visualization experience. It provides unit visualization for the data you would like to explore and visualize in SandDance. So here, I'm installing the SandDance extension, as you can see, the SandDance extension was just installed. So let's go back to where the data is. So I have data inside the SQL Server Big Data Cluster, and the SQL Server Big Data Cluster comes with HDFS with the Big Data Cluster, where you can store high volume of data. And one such data which I have stored in the HDFS instance of SQL Server Big Data Cluster is a demo vote.tsv. So now let's take a look at how this data looks like. So if you do a quick preview of the data, the data sets opens from HDFS, and as you can see, this is nothing but voting data. It has the voting data during the Obama-Romney timeframe of elections which happened across the United States. Now, if I have to process this particular data set and give it to my data scientist to actually make sense from the data, he would have to actually build some reports, and whether he uses data visualization libraries to actually view it, or he uses some sort of code to actually visualize what the data looks like. But in Azure Data Studio, we have a right-click option of View in SandDance. And let's take a look at how this data looks like. Now, you can see that SandDance is loading up, and SandDance actually auto-figured out that this data has latitude, longitude, and scatter plot would be the best chart to choose for plotting this particular data. So we have a recommender chart type built inside SandDance. So now this data looks good. I can see that the map of the United States as expected because the voting data, and I have the x-axis and the y-axis as well. Now, still, I don't know if there are more information in the data, and I could obviously filter in terms of the x-axis and the y-axis, but wouldn't it be great if I could actually plot this in a three-dimensional space to actually see which one might be the best classifier? So let's make this graph a three-dimensional one. So if I click at SandDance, and if I click the three-dimensional one, now I have z-axis. Now in the z-axis, I can choose income and see across the United States what the income demographics of the people are. You can see that Washington is doing good, Bay Area is doing a little better, and then in New York and Miami is great as well. So, but let's take a look at, in terms of the median home value, how are the prices looking? And you can see that the graph automatically adjusted itself. You could also have a various color schemas you can use. So I could actually see income, and you can see that I can choose different color schemas to actually color the graph. I could also easily change the bin count size. So I could actually, you could see that as I change the bin count, the graph dynamically just changes completely. Okay, now this is good. I could also visualize the data, zoom in, zoom out. But now I would like to see if this data set is giving me some sort of a way of where I could predict some anomalies if that exists inside the data. So now let's start by doing some search on top of the data. So I'm going to search where income is less than, say, $40,000. And also add another expression and say median home value is greater than $800,000. That seems to be a good check. Let's see if we can find some data set which actually satisfies this need. Now, If I actually do a search and select, you can see that SandDance has a couple of data points which it actually picked it up. Those are shown in the graph. I could easily isolate these data points. And now I just have a subset of these four data points to consider. You can see that there is a person in San Miguel County who has bought a house of $812,500 with an income of $39,070. So SandDance actually gives you unit visualization of the data you are trying to explore and make sense from the data. You could also do other things like where you can take a snapshot of the picture. You want to create a snapshot view, you could actually create a snapshot. And it creates a snapshot view. Now you can embed this snapshot view in a document which you want to probably send it over to someone else to take a look at as well. So this is the way we are providing data visualization in the context of the data you are operating in. Now also, one of the things we have added also inside SandDance was the ability to visualize the query results. So here I have a database I have created, and in this particular database I have a sensor data table. So now if I do a select top 1000 from that particular table, and I could also click on this chart here and load this data in the SandDance visualizer. Though this is just a sensor data and it does not have as interesting as the voting data is, but still this gives you a quick view of what the data visualization in the context of the query could be like. Now, in this particular video, you have seen how we are using SandDance to actually quickly visualize the data and make meaningful trends and understand what the trends are happening from the data so that it can help you in building advanced machine learning algorithms. Thank you so much for listening in today.